Buster. Gentlemen, welcome to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross here at ringside, and we've got a phenomenal program, ladies and gentlemen. You are going to see the Z-Man challenge Ravishing Rick Rude. We are also going to see the World Tag Team Champions, Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson, in tag team competition. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, for the television championship, it will be Stunning Steve Austin being challenged by a man that is on a mission of revenge. I'm speaking of the big Texan from Sweetwater, Barry Windham. But last week, right before we went off the air, you saw the Dangerous Alliance leave Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner lying in the ring. What an attack by the Dangerous Alliance. I don't think they want to face the Steiner brothers for the World Tag Team Championship. But right now, I'd like to take you and hear some pre-recorded comments made earlier today from Rick and from Scott Steiner. They want the World Tag titles, and here's what they had to say to the Dangerous Alliance.
Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson, me and my brother, this is a challenge to you for this World Tag Team titles. But when the match came down, Arn Anderson, you walked away. Why? We challenged you, not Larry and Bobby, so that we wrestled the match and we beat Larry, 1, 2, 3 in the middle. Then you stop us, kick us, punch us after the match. That don't matter. What matters is what happens from bell to bell. That's what matters. You can punch us, kick us, all you want. We don't care. Paulie, Dangerously, sooner or later, you're going to have to put your two best men forward. But the best two men ain't be good enough. Larry Zbysko, what you did was drop me on the part of my body that matters less. I got right on my head. Nothing there, nothing to worry about. What you got to worry about now is what you're going to come up with to be me and my brother. It ain't going to happen. There ain't nothing you can do to stop it.
And now, fans, here's a look at the WCW Top 10 Rankings and Singles Competition for the weekend of Saturday, February 1st, as compiled by promoters and members of the WCW Board of Directors. The number 10 spot for Vero Beach, Florida, the Tailor-Made Man. In at number 9, the Wild Man from the Sudan at 460 pounds, Abdullah the Butcher. Big Van Vader checks in at number 8. In at number 7, Cactus Jack. The Natural Dustin Rhodes one step ahead at number 6. At number 5, returning from the injury, the All-American Ron Simmons. The number 4 ranked contender from Charlotte, North Carolina, the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. The World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin, ranks number 3 this week. The number 2 ranked contender, the Stinger from Venice Beach. The number 1 ranked contender, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. And of course, the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, the Total Package, Lex Luger. And that's a look at this week's Top 10 Rankings.
Wrestling fans, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the Chief Executive Officer of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously. They are the WCW World Tag Team Champions. First from Minnesota, 260 pounds, AA, Arn Anderson. And from Huntsville, Alabama, 238 pounds, Beautiful Bobby.
Well, the World Tag Team Champions come to the ring. Fans, I must remind you, we'll have two major announcements in the WCW Magazine later in the hour about Super Brawl.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. Introducing first from Tampa, Florida, 208 pounds, Mike Graham. His tag team partner from Cincinnati, Ohio, 225 pounds, Flying Ryan.
Fans, we'll get this tag team battle underway after this very brief timeout.
Open sesame.
Hey, Joe, we're down to the last Butterfinger.
Ah! The last Butterfinger!
Simpson going deep.
Get a crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery burst in every bite of Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Double, double your refreshments. Double, double your enjoyment. Oh, no single gum. Double freshens your mouth like double mint gum. Double, double your refreshments. Double, double your delight. Oh, no single gum. Double freshens your mouth like double fresh, double good. Come on and double mint gum.
There's no single gum like it.
The actual size of a Jolly Rancher candy is 3/4 of an inch by 3/4 of an inch square. But the actual taste of a Jolly Rancher candy is immeasurable. Jolly Rancher candy, the great taste of fruit squared.
WCW's 1-900-909-9900 hotline. Call the hottest hotline. On Sunday, it's Missy Does Mail. Monday, Tony Schiavone Talks. Tuesday, Matt Watch with Steve Beverly. Wednesday, Late Breaking News with Dennis Brent. Thursday, it's Straight Up with Sting. Friday, Lex on the Level. And Saturday, catch the Jim Ross Report. Plus, get the chance to randomly talk with WCW wrestling celebrities live. Call the hottest hotline. 1-900-909-9900. $2 for the first minute, 45 cents every minute thereafter. Children under 18 must get parental permission.
Carrie Jacobson's a milk drinker. Once I saw her, I had to meet her. She says milk helps with shiny hair and beautiful skin. She's right, she's gorgeous. She gets a lot of attention. For me, she gets total attention. Milk does a body good.
Sunday, America is under siege, and a one-man army is her only hope. It's time for a real hero. Chuck Norris, Invasion USA. 10:35 Eastern, Sunday morning on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bell has sounded, and this is a special challenge event. Dangerously did not allow a signature to be signed to make this a championship event. Beautiful Bobby and Arn Anderson, a phenomenal team. There is no doubt about that. I think they're the two best tag team wrestlers that I have ever seen. That man with a dynamic left hand, his partner with the awesome right hand. But they're in there with a great mat tactician in Mike Graham. Man, what a situation here last week. That man doesn't want his team to face the Steiners. Anderson with the hammerlock, quickly reversed by Mike Graham. Graham, a phenomenal mat wrestler. Great innate skills. Fast-paced beginning of this contest. Graham. Master of the figure four, we've seen it before, and Anderson wanted no part of that. Vance, while we have the opportunity, remember the main event returns to TBS tomorrow with Tony Schiavone and Missy Hyatt. Big Ron Simmons and Abdullah the Butcher will be partners, if you can believe that, to take on Larry Zbyszko of the Dangerous Alliance and Cactus Jack. Main event tomorrow at 6:05 Eastern. Anderson controlling it now, side headlock. Shoulder block. Graham's got to distance himself somewhat here. And Graham stepped in. Abdominal stretch. Right in the center of the ring. Great leverage move by Graham, but Anderson with a handful of hair and his strength is too strong for Graham. And Graham the arm drag takeover into the arm bar. And Graham now working on the bicep. And it's the left arm. Great strategy to work on the left arm of Anderson. Maybe he can lessen the strength of the southpaw. Vance will take another look at the biggest matchup ever signed in WCW, Sting and Lex Luger for the world title. A special feature on those two men. And something they have in common. We'll show you that in this hour. Anderson back up to a vertical base as Graham executes the arm bar.
Cameras look over the shoulder of Paul E. Dangerously, CEO of the Dangerous Alliance. Graham made the tag to Flying Bryant. Anderson caught, coming in, over the top, a near fall. And Anderson requests a timeout, leaving the ring very confused there. They made a tag, but Anderson didn't see it as he was crisscrossing.
Hey, hey, you're going to make these two jerks get you upset. Art Anderson, the great Art Anderson, you can't let them get you upset.
Dangerously with some motivating words for Arn Anderson. World Tag Team Champions. And I'd love to see them meet the Steiners for the World Tag Title. But I'm not so sure Dangerously will ever sign a contract for that match. Beautiful Bobby in. Collar and elbow, back in the ropes, he took the advantage, right hand. Irish whip, but Pillman put the brakes on. Head scissor, takes him up and down. Great aerial movement by Flying Bryant. Arm drag takeover. Great quickness and Dangerously a little bit frustrated. You can't work out and simulate the quickness of a man like Flying Bryant. He is just unbelievably agile and quick. And what a heck of a deal here last week. Bobbing Flying Bryant and Johnny B. Badd and Richard Morton and Brad Armstrong and confetti and all kinds of other stuff. Very competitive environment for the light heavyweight division. Look at this movement by Pillman. Right on the leg of Anderson. And Anderson may have been injured right there as Pillman came off, going for a cross body, but I think he caught him in the leg, may have hyperextended the knee of Arn Anderson. Anderson back up on the apron, and Anderson says, that's it for you, Pillman. Anderson trying to keep the stiffness out of his knee, it's his left knee, I believe. Anderson very dangerous in this environment, and a left hand caught Pillman. Another left finds its mark. What a dynamic move by Flying Bryant Pillman. Two more championship matches will be announced later in this hour for Super Brawl 92. As now Graham, great veteran strategy, trying to work on the leg. But he's overpowered now. He's in the corner of the World Tag Champions. But Graham trying to fight out. He's successfully doing so. Oh, and a thumb right to the eye. You can see that. He got the thumb right in the eye. And it's blinded by Graham. Tag made. Eaton and Anderson make the exchange here. And this is a well-oiled machine. They have no wasted motion. They take very little unnecessary chances. Double team. Graham now in a great deal of difficulty. Well, he's on the phone again. Assuming he's talking to either Zabisco or Rude, maybe Medusa. Near fall. Graham showing great tenacity. Able to kick out before three. Graham Graham trying to work his way back up. Really needs to make a tag, and Liam Bryan is ready for it. And he made the tag. But beautiful Bobby diverted the referee's attention. Referee's not going to allow it because he didn't see it. In the meantime, they were doubling up on Graham. Flying Bryan in. Great explosiveness from this youngster from Cincinnati. Graham with a snap mare. Graham now going back for the figure four. But watch Bobby, the left part of your screen. Graham is helpless, can't defend himself, and he got mashed right in the face with the Alabama Jam. And they're gonna win it here. The champions win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the dangerous alliance of Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby.
Well, whether you like him or you hate him, it was resourcefulness and teamwork. Great move here by Flying Bryan, who looked phenomenal in this matchup. But Mike Graham with a figure four on Anderson caught helplessly, and it was the Alabama Jam. But you gotta think somewhere, sometime, the Steiners will get their chance against the Dangerous Alliance and the WCW Magazine and those major announcements coming up next.
The superstars of World Championship Wrestling are coming to a location near you. Make sure you're at the Omni in Atlanta Sunday night, February 9th, so you can see Sting. It's Larry Zbyszko at the Bayfront Center in St. Pete, Saturday night, February 8th. Ricky Steamboat will be right at the Coliseum in Jacksonville this Friday night at 8 o'clock. The Diamond Stud will be a part of the show at the Civic Center in Savannah this Thursday night. And this Monday, you'll want to make sure you're at the Civic Center in Montgomery, Alabama, to check out the Steiner Brothers. Mr. Hughes is on the card at the Civic Center in Philadelphia, PA. Tomorrow night, bell time of 7:30. But tonight, it's the University Hall in Charlottesville, Virginia. The site for more hard-hitting action. The All-American Ron Simmons will be there. You'll want to be there, too. Bell time of 8 o'clock tonight. University Hall in Charlottesville.
For 2 years, Isaiah Thomas and Dennis Rodman have had Atlanta's number. Kevin Wilkes has had enough. The Pistons take on the Hawks live at 7:35 Eastern tonight on TBS.
What is real?
Is that for real?
That can't be real.
What about her? Is she for real?
Well, what is real?
This is real.
Skittles.
Tart and tangy. Wildberry. Tropical. Real fun. Real good. With real fruit juices.
Skittles. Bite-sized candy.
Taste the rainbow.
Be afraid. Be very afraid. One life-sucking Metroid survived the first Metroid adventure, and it's multiplying rapidly. You must help Samus save the universe again in Metroid 2. So we're giving you more power and mightier weapons to search a bigger world where hundreds of strange enemy life forms lurk. Destroy or be destroyed.
Metroid 2, The Return of Samus, only on Game Boy.
The future is in your hands.
Wrestling fans all over the world are rushing to get the best wrestling merchandise anywhere. WCW merchandise, with not only the greatest selection of grappling memorabilia around, but made with the quality you've come to expect from the WCW. And now you can write or call to WCW merchandise and get a free catalog. So write now to WCW merchandise, P.O. Box 105-716, Atlanta, Georgia, 303-48-5716, or call 404-827-4607. Do it now.
What do you do if every time you see this incredible woman, you think you're gonna hurl?
I say hurl. If you blow chunks and she comes back, she's yours.
Okay.
Wayne's World, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, February 14th.
Head and shoulders for my serious dandruff? Uh-uh. Blue is better. Extra medicated Selsun Blue.
With a medicine doctors recommend most. Medicine that relieves flaking better than Head and Shoulders.
Blue is better.
Selsun Blue, doctor recommended number one.
You, my friend, can use some fun.
big fun. Las Vegas, Atlantic City, cruise ships. But you got to take this along, the Players Club card. It's going to save you a lot of money. 25 to 50% off fabulous resort hotels, 25% off meals and drinks, up to 50% off shows and entertainment. Come on, call Players Club for much more information free. You're too smart to pay full price.
New members get two free nights in Las Vegas or Atlantic City when the club books their flights. Call toll free now.
It's Guy's Night Out with Rick Moranis. Strange Brew, followed by Kevin Bacon and Mickey Rourke. Diner. It all begins at 11 Eastern tonight on TBS Nightflix.
Welcome back to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this is a WCW magazine. With Super Brawl 2 only 4 weeks away, the anticipation continues to grow as we eagerly await the world's heavyweight title showdown between the Total Package, Lex Luger, and his former friend, Sting. This is already the most talked about world title bout in WCW history. We have comments from each athlete regarding their championship meeting that is less than 1 month away. Let's hear them now.
Tuesday night was a big night. Last Tuesday night, the Clash of Champions, Luger makes his big announcement. I get to walk down the aisle. Tony Schiavone, Jesse Ventura, lots of good stuff happened in World Championship Wrestling. Tony says, Sting, look up at the big screen. Luger's got an announcement to make, and then he says, Sting, I have the choice because I'm world champion to stay at home, work out, get into the best shape of my life. You're going to be on the road wrestling every single day leading up to that match. Sounds like you want to try and wear me out, doesn't it? You ought to know by now you can't wear me out. Thing that stands out most in my mind is you saying, Sting, you're just going to be another chapter in my book that says I will go on as the greatest champion, the greatest athlete of all time. Listen to me. Look into my eyes right now. I'm telling you something! I've proved myself time and time again, and I'm going to continue to do it even when I face you, pal.
You know, a lot's been said about the seclusion of Lex Luger as of late. I call it the champion's prerogative. I call it preparation, both mentally. I'm getting in tune for the biggest event, the biggest match of my career, like I never have before. It's called concentration. It's called focusing on one thing and one thing only, and that's victory. Physically, I am in the finest condition of my life. My training regimen has never been more severe. I am totally and absolutely prepared like I never have before in my lifetime for this match coming up. A lot's been said about friendship. Friendship is put aside when you step through those ropes and the bell sounds. It's all business, and Lex Luger takes care of business. That's why I'm the world's heavyweight champion. That's why, when it's all written, the storybook career of the Total Package, Lex Luger, I just don't want to be the greatest wrestling champion of all time. I want to be known as the greatest athlete of all time. So when it's all said and done, Sting, after that match, you will just be another chapter in the storybook career of the greatest wrestler and the greatest athlete who ever lived, the Total Package, Lex Luger.
In addition to that collision, WCW officials have announced this weekend two more title bouts for Super Brawl 2. Ravishing Rick Rude will defend the United States heavyweight title against the spectacular Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Now, many of you witnessed what happened at the Clash of Champions involving Rude, the Dangerous Alliance, and the Dragon. Let's take a quick look back at that situation, and then we'll hear comments from these two men who will meet for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship at Super Brawl 2.
Rude Awakening! Rude Awakening on a already weakened Ricky the Dragon Steamboat! Sting went for the Stinger, splash, but he missed!
And now's when Paulie and the boys are going to do the damage!
Oh, no, not another one! There's no reason for this, the second Rude Awakening!
I think the Dragon's been awakened!
The human anatomy cannot sustain this, and now he's got that belt! Oh, my God!
Oh. He's giving him a good old-fashioned country whipper!
Ravishing Rick Rude, now Ricky Steamboat wants your title at Super Brawl 2.
Super Brawl 2, 1992, what a night it's gonna be! Two great gladiators, Ricky Steamboat, Ravishing Rick Rude, bumping heads in the middle of the ring. The people want to see it, so let's give it to them. Ricky Steamboat, Super Brawl 2, let's get ready to rumble.
Right in the peak of my wrestling career, I've got Ravishing Rick Rude right here at Super Brawl 2. Paulie, dangerously, if you happen to stick your nose in the business of our match, it will be thoroughly chopped off. This is an opportunity for the Dragon. But as every wrestling fan and wrestler knows, that when my back is up against the wall at any big event, at any pay-per-view, that I come home with the gold. Ravishing Rick Rude, be aware of the Dragon, for you will get the Rude Awakening.
I understand a special stipulation could be added to this match. However, no details were available as we went on the air today. We'll keep you updated on this situation. WCW officials are also proud to announce that Jushin Thunder Liger will return to the United States to defend his WCW World's Light Heavyweight title against Flying Brian Pillman at Super Brawl 2. Liger narrowly defeated Pillman Christmas night at Atlanta's Omni to win the championship in what was one of the most dynamic and exciting bouts ever in WCW. The rematch should be even more memorable. We will most certainly have more announcements next weekend here on TBS regarding Super Brawl 2. Already, we know that Luger will meet Sting for the World's Heavyweight title, Ravishing Rick Rude and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat for the United States Heavyweight Championship, and all the way from Japan, Jushin Thunder Liger will meet Flying Brian Pillman for the WCW World's Light Heavyweight title. And with the addition of Jesse the Body Ventura, you do not want to miss Super Brawl 2. Be sure to contact your local cable company and order Super Brawl 2 Saturday, February 29th, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, live from the Mecca Arena in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. More WCW action continues in just a moment. I'm Eric Bischoff reminding you to pick up your personal copy of WCW Magazine. It's available at newsstands nationwide. We'll be back.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
General Nutrition can help you break the mold with Cybergenics in one incredible kit. Supplements, manuals, and videotape. Cybergenics at GNC.
The Murine Earwax Removal System has drops that safely loosen wax, plus an ear washer to gently flush wax away. Murine, the complete medically approved earwax removal system.
Size of a Jolly Rancher candy is 3/4 of an inch by 3/4 of an inch square. But the actual taste of a Jolly Rancher candy is immeasurable. Jolly Rancher candy, the great taste of fruit squared.
The story continues. WCW Magazine, the official publication of World Championship Wrestling.
Awesome!
Not just a catalog, but page after page of everything you want in a magazine.
It's really big.
Hard-hitting features and inside information.
I can't believe they printed that.
And you can save 33% on your subscription.
Yo, subscribe today and save some pay.
On newsstands worldwide, it's WCW Magazine.
It's totally massive.
Milk is sure helping me get stronger. Back when I started high school, guys pushed me around. Just because I was smaller. But I was working out, drinking milk, developing my muscles. By senior year, milk had made a difference.
Pardon me, guys.
I love this part.
Pardon me, guys.
So as you can see, it pays to be big on milk. Milk. It does a body good.
Ayo! Mm. Now, little spike-headed one.
Uh-oh.
First lesson.
Oh, man.
Lesson number two. Ah, now we take butterfinger break.
Get a crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery burst in every bite of butterfinger.
Lesson number three. Nobody better lay a finger on my butterfinger.
My health club always had Pert Plus in the locker room. It cleans, conditions, it's great. And one day they switched. This one said it had conditioner in it, but my hair told a different story.
Some two-in-ones don't lather as well or leave hair feeling as clean. Others don't fully condition. But Pert Plus's microbead conditioner leaves hair clean and completely conditioned.
So now when I go to my club, my Pert Plus goes with me.
Pert Plus, there's no two-in-one like this one.
Kerry Jacobson's a milk drinker.
Once I saw her, I had to meet her. She says milk helps with shiny hair and beautiful skin. She's right, she's gorgeous. She gets a lot of attention. For me, she gets total attention. Milk does a body good.
Kevin Johnson drives the right side for the Suns. Nowhere to go. Punch it back outside to Tom Chambers. 20-footer on the way. The goal!
This week in the NBA. Beginning Sunday, 11:30 Eastern on CNN.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Nevada, weighing 300 pounds, Vinny Vegas. And from Kansas City, 375 pounds, the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes. And they are accompanied by former heavyweight champion, Harley Race. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, introducing first, from Baltimore, Maryland, 224 pounds, jumping, Joey Maggs. Marietta, Georgia, 233 pounds, Brad Armstrong.
Couple of great light heavyweights, Armstrong and Maggs, to challenge this huge team, both well over 300 pounds, and their advisor, a real legend in his own time, no doubt about it, seven times world champion, Harley Race. Race, from what I hear, has been studying videotape of Sting. He has been deeply, deeply involved in the workout regimen of one of his associates, the heavyweight champion of the world, the total package, Lex Luger. And Race knows what it's like to train for championship matches. Goodness knows he's had plenty of them. And you know this team right here that he's bringing along, a couple of young studs here, certainly have a phenomenal amount of potential. And I'll tell you one thing, when Ray speaks, they listen. He is like a coach, real hard-nosed football coach. Big Mr. Hughes, I'm very impressed with him in recent weeks. Big and agile, 375 at least. And double team, and then neither, both men could get him down. Double drop kick by both Armstrong and Maggs, and Armstrong can execute as good a drop kick as anybody I've ever seen, and both together could take the big man off his feet. Fans, don't forget, WCW returns to Atlanta's Omni on Sunday, February the 9th. 7:30 starting time in the Omni on the 9th, which is a week from tomorrow. Big Vinny Vegas first on the scene at the Clash of Champions. And at the Clash of the Champions, he won his match. And we saw a little bit of his personality. Very arrogant guy. Very cocky, but obviously very, very gifted physically. He's got to be 6'10", maybe 7 feet. Got a move called the Snake Eyes. We saw it to Clash. Very impressive. Got a near fall there. There's a tag. Well, they almost dress alike. No shades for Vinny Vegas. Doesn't want anybody to miss his eyes, I guess. Brad Armstrong, so quick, so highly skilled. But at 233, giving away well over 100 pounds. How much can you expect from a young man with that kind of physical disadvantage? I'm sure Brad would love to have the position anointed to fly in Brian, as Brian Pillman, as you heard, will meet Jushin Thunder Liger. Super Brawl 2 for the light heavyweight title. Of course, that other dynamic announcement, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat to challenge Ravishing Rick Rude for the U.S. title. We'll hear some comments from the Dragon later in the broadcast, and we'll see Ravishing Rick Rude take on the Z-Man. later here today on WCW. Anytime Vegas and Hughes can slow it down and just use raw power, they're going to have a decided advantage. What a right hand right below the heart. Bigfoot. I don't know how big his feet are. They look like about a 14, maybe a 15, I'm guessing. Gut wrench into a side salto suplex. And he's rolling the dice. And it may come up snake eyes for Brad Armstrong. He really needs to make a tag here. There's an exchange. That wasn't the tag I was referring to. Brad needs the tag. These two big monsters are doing pretty well without the tags. And it's hard to believe we're only 28 days from Super Brawl 2. Armstrong up and over. He won't get him down. Hughes widened out his base. Now he's signaling how smart he is. And his advisor, Harley Race, giving the instructions. Very impressive thus far. Big elbow! Race signaled for the elbow, and he got it. Well, actually, Armstrong got it, but it was a... And Brad able to slip out. Just slip out from underneath Mr. Hughes. Race verbally assaulting Brad Armstrong. And he took a chance. And he didn't pay off. Joey Maggs now in. We'll see what the young fireball from Baltimore can do with the big boys. Joey looks like a little kid in there. 224, he's no little man. I don't think that hurt him. I think the large one is rather angry now. Hughes. Man, what an evil, evil individual. Hip lock into a power slam. He changed that hold in midair. He started with a hip lock, changed it to a power slam, and drilled him. Maggs is in deep trouble. That will be the understatement of the day. And here it comes. Snake eyes. A roll of the dice. And it may come up snake eyes for jumping Joey Maggs. Oh, man. That was right above me, fans. His face was just rammed into the top turnbuckle. Harley Race has got a find here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Vinny Vegas and the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes.
Well, we have a moment here. I'm going to try to talk to Harley Race and those two, but let's take another look at the snake eyes. Indeed, it came up that way for Joey Maggs. Mr. Race, I would say you have a potentially a very dominant tag team.
Well, first off, let me say that Lex Luger is into the greatest workout routine of any human being on the face of the earth. You've already saw Van Beter, and you know what he can do. Now, when I get this combination right here in the right gear and they're headed straight forward, what do you think is going to be around that can stop it?
It'd take a great team to stop these guys.
Tell them, big man, tell them.
First off, I want to say what an honor it is to work with the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes. And I'm under the expert tutelage of one of the most respected men ever to walk in a squared circle, Harley Race. The cards have been dealt, people. It's real simple. What you got here is a pair that'll beat a full house any day of the week. So, when you see us come to your town, baby, only one thing's gonna happen. We're gonna win. Don't ever, ever bet against Vinny Vegas and his man, Mr. Hughes.
Quite a combination, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll have more on WCW right after this timeout.
What do you do if every time you see this incredible woman, you think you're gonna hurl?
I say hurl. If you blow chunks and she comes back, she's yours.
Okay.
Wayne's World, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, February 14th.
Bart, I'm gonna open my mouth and close my eyes, and you're gonna give me a big surprise.
Crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Hey, did you bring any money?
Nope.
Did you bring the map?
Nope.
What did you bring?
The tunes, man. Southern rock.
It's Southern Rock. Over 2 hours of guitar wailing jams by bands like the Allman Brothers, Lynyrd Skynyrd. With Southern Rock, you get all the classics from the 70s to the 90s together for the first time.
The devil went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal.
If you'll be my Tennessee man.
With Southern Rock, you get three cassettes or two CDs, a double dose of Dixie's finest.
Boys, where'd you get those tunes?
Time Life, sir.
Here's how to order. To order your Southern Rock, call 1-800-257-1234 or send $19.99 for three cassettes or $24.99 for two compact discs. Plus $4 shipping and handling to Southern Rock, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia.
Sunday, America is under siege, and a one-man army is her only hope. It's time for a real hero. Chuck Norris, Invasion USA, 10:35 Eastern, Sunday morning on TBS.
It's a voyage of technological artistry, created through scientific thought, designed on a space-aged canvas, producing a manufacturing phenomenon. It's the Soloflex Muscle Machine. Call now and take your body on an incredible voyage to renewed beauty. Soloflex, 21st century design for today's needs.
The bigger they are, the harder they jam.
Oh, yes.
The NBA's best. Look back. Look sharp and look to the sky. All-Star Saturday, February 8th on TNT.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Marietta, Georgia, weighing 235 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bagwell. His opponent from Los Angeles, California, 284 pounds, Mark Kyle.
Big Mark Kyle will pose a stern test for the rookie Marcus Alexander Bagwell. I'm going to try to have another conversation later today with Mr. Bagwell. As if you remember, last week he was rather rudely interrupted by the tailor-made man. Fireman carry takeover. Bagwell's got to be cautious of Mark Kyle. Kyle's a real strong, physical individual. Bagwell at 235 gives away a lot of weight in this contest, a lot of bulk. Good counter move. He'll have to use his quickness, as that will be his primary offensive advantage in this one. Kyle has the advantage in experience. Great move there. Good agility. Hip lock takeover. Nicely done. Catching Kyle coming up with a drop kick. Really coming along. Nice young man too, ladies and gentlemen. Very polite. So happy to be here. As Minnie Pearl used to say. And she still may say it, I don't know. Kyle, that kick right to the gut. He's a brawler. Straight right hand, caught the kid in the face now. Look glassy-eyed now. They didn't hit like that at Sprayberry High School in Marietta. And Kyle moved out of the way, arm drag takeover. That's the way you neutralize that strength. Take him down, put him on the mat. Fans are still to come, another look at the remarkable similarities of the careers of Sting and Lex Luger. Last week we showed them to you against a common opponent. This week we'll show you them in action winning U.S. championships. They've both been the U.S. heavyweight champion. More on that in the broadcast. 28 days and counting. Be a long time until there's a 29th of February again. Leap year day, Super Brawl 92. Nice elevation, the back body drop. He's really moving the big man around now. Building the momentum. And that's a good move. Kyle said early, he suplexed him, and he's going to win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Marcus Alexander Bagwell, fired up and happy to be here on TBS and in WCW. Nice high impact clothesline, and he follows it up with a perfectly done suplex. Ladies and gentlemen, another great victory for Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Last week we got interrupted, had a lot of things I want to tell you about, but again, great fans here. You're getting great fan support all over America.
It's really great, Jim. It's a great feeling to know you come into a professional wrestling like I have. The WCW has accepted me, and so are these great fans. I'm just happy to be here, and I'm going to give it my best shot.
You've certainly been doing that great effort displayed. Hey, wait.
Great match, Marcus, great match, but I got something to say, so why don't you just run along? I got something to say.
Oh, I checked with the director, Jim. Correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. Ross. This is my interview time.
You're exactly right. This is his interview time.
Ross, hold the microphone. That's your job. Let me tell you, I've been around a long time. It's time for you to go. Go on, run along. Go on. It's your time to leave.
Go on. Mr. Ross, I don't want to cause any problems. I just want to be in the WCW. I don't have no problems right now. I'm going to give the man what he wants.
All right, young man. There'll be another day for you out here. Yeah, thanks.
I got my Learjet waiting at the airport, and I can't be standing around here waiting for a rookie. I'm heading out to London to get some clothes made because I am the best-dressed man. I am the best-looking man. And when I get in that ring, you're going to see how good the tailor-made man really is. So no matter what any of you say, I am going to the top of WCW because I am tailor-made.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, again interrupting Marcus Alexander Bagwell is a tailor-made man, and we'll be back right after this timeout.
Do you want to be a star among WCW superstars? Well, here's your big chance. You may become an official WCW ring announcer by entering WCW's Ringside Roundup Contest. One grand prize winner gets a trip for two to Super Bowl II, plus hotel accommodations and spending money. Then, it's your chance to be in the spotlight and announce at WCW's biggest spectacular event, Super Bowl II. 20 first prize winners will have an opportunity to announce WCW events in each winner's area. 3 second prize winners will receive a Panasonic palm quarter. 100 third place winners will receive a WCW videotape. To enter, simply send a 1 minute home video of you as a ring announcer. Be creative, be original, show your style. Mail your videotaped audition with your name, address, phone number, and age to WCW Ringside Roundup, P.O. Box 19997, Atlanta, Georgia, 30325. Enter today for your shot at WCW stardom. February 29th, Super Brawl 2! Best friends become bitter foes as Lex Luger and Sting brawl for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship, and Ravishing Rick Rude tangles with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat for the U.S. Heavyweight title. Super Brawl 2! Live and only on pay-per-view. Call your local cable operator for availability.
She's been gone for 20 years. But still, she's the greatest gospel singer of them all. And now, in a special TV treasury, here's Mahalia Jackson singing gospel as only she can. You get Mahalia singing hard. Sweet singing Mahalia. Hand clapping Mahalia. Mahalia sings her soul out.
My soul.
All her greatest hits are here. This album is not sold in any store. Order by calling toll-free now, and you'll get another Mahalia treasury with songs that stirred America, like her hit from the movie Imitation of Life.
Will be done. Trouble.
Songs for all seasons. No one can sing them like Mahalia Jackson. Call now and hear the song she sang at the March on Washington. And Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s touching last request. Write this toll-free number down and call now. You get both Mahalia Jackson treasuries on records or cassettes for only $14.98. Long play CD, only $16.98. There'll never be another Mahalia. Be sure to order yours now.
Carrie Jacobson's a milk drinker. Once I saw her, I had to meet her. She says milk helps with shiny hair and beautiful skin. She's right, she's gorgeous. She gets a lot of attention. For me, she gets total attention. Milk does a body good.
Television's best sports team is the first word in sports. Coverage of the day's sports action, in-depth analysis, behind-the-scenes interviews. CNN Sports Tonight, the first word in sports at 11 p.m. Eastern on CNN.
Here last week, we're going to be following the careers of Lex Luger and Sting, and they're very interesting parallels from now until Super Brawl when they meet for the World's Heavyweight Championship. Let's take a look at this video feature. Remember, both men were United States champions.
11 men entered, and there's a clothesline. And it has come down to these final two. Stunning Steve, you can hear him talking. I guess, honey, he's referring to Letty Blossom, not my good friend Rhubarb Jones, who's here at ringside. He's got him up, and there's a stun gun. That will be all. If he covers him, that's it. Well, Austin's got him right here. Sting cannot get up with a stun gun, but Austin again embracing Lady Blossom. She thinks the thing has already won, obviously. Austin may regret not capitalizing after the stun gun. Gut wrench suplex. He's got him up. Trying to go for a tombstone pile driver. Sting's countered it. He's got it countered. Boom. The tombstone pile driver. The Stinger now perhaps has turned the momentum. Lady Blossom celebrating. She thinks it's Stunning Steve, but he doesn't have a spiked haircut. The Stinger now trying to regroup, but he could be pinned. He's been rolled up. One, two. The Stinger counters. He's got the legs neutralized. The shoulder's down, and he wins it.
And it's Luger. who drops a leg on Hansen. Remember, Luger has never wrestled in this type of match before, but he has adapted quite well.
What Luger needs to do here is tie Stan Hansen up. If he can tie Hansen up, then there's no way that Stan can recuperate. There's no way that Stan can escape. He got the hands tied already.
Luger got one post or one turnbuckle. Hansen just trying to go dead weight there, make Luger pull and exert all the energy and strength that he can. He got him again. That's the second round for Luger. He's halfway there to regaining his championship. It kicks Hansen back down.
He's inches away, but it's a long few inches.
He cut the post. He did it. And next week, we'll have another very special in-depth look at both these phenomenal athletes as they prepare to battle at Super Brawl 2 for the heavyweight championship of the world exclusively on pay-per-view. And when we come back, the Stinger himself will be here live.
Sunday night, the Dirty Dozen is back. Lee Marvin trains 12 convicted killers to take on the whole Nazi army.
All right, now let's do it.
This is their last chance for a one-way ticket out of hell. If they refuse, they die. Lee Marvin, Ernest Borgnine, Ken Wall, the Dirty Dozen, the next mission. 7 Eastern, Sunday night on TBS.
Open sesame.
Hey, Joe, we're down to the last Butterfinger.
Ah! The last Butterfinger!
Simpson going deep.
Get a crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery burst in every bite of Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, stay close a little longer, hold tight a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness lasts right through it. Your fresh breath goes on and on. While you chew it, say goodbye a little longer, make it last a little longer. Give your breath long-lasting freshness.
Wrestling fans all over the world are rushing to get the best wrestling merchandise anywhere. WCW merchandise, with not only the greatest selection of grappling memorabilia around, but made with the quality you come to expect from the WCW. And now you can write or call to WCW merchandise and get a free catalog. So write now to WCW merchandise, P.O. Box 105716, Atlanta, Georgia, 303-48-5716, or call 404-827-4607. Do it now.
What do you do if every time you see this incredible woman, you think you're gonna hurl?
I say hurl. If you blow chunks and she comes back, she's yours.
Okay.
Wayne's World, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, February 14th.
Carrie Jacobson's a milk drinker. Once I saw her, I had to meet her. She says milk helps with shiny hair and beautiful skin. She's right, she's gorgeous. She gets a lot of attention. For me, she gets total attention. Milk does a body good.
It's Guy's Night Out with Rick Moranis. Strange Brew, followed by Kevin Bacon and Mickey Rourke. Diner. It all begins at 11 Eastern tonight on TBS Nightflix.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Venice Beach, California, weighing 251 pounds, America, this is... His opponent from Frankfort, Kentucky, 276 pounds, Mike Semples.
Fans, the Stinger has something to say earlier today. Let's hear these comments.
Oh, Luger, you're at home right now. I've been thinking about, should I really be at home, resting and working out, trying to get in good shape? Maybe you should be in the ring, wrestling, staying at the top of your game, like I'm doing.
Mike Sample's trying to gain the early advantage on the Stinger. And that may be the only chance that Samples has. He's a big, rough, tough man, but no one has been able to slow the Stinger down. He and Luger to meet at Super Brawl, but he has got some tremendous challenges awaiting him in the next 28 days. I'm sure that if Luger and men like the Dangerous Alliance have their way, Sting would not make it till Milwaukee and Super Brawl 2. This phenomenal athlete, 1 week from tomorrow, will be in the Omni in Atlanta. That's Sunday, February 9th in the Omni, 7:30 starting time. And he is so intense right now. Much like Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. As they both prepare to attempt to win major championships, but none bigger than the one Sting will attempt to win. The Stinger Splash. And now the Scorpion Deathlock. And not even the magnificence of Lex Luger can withstand the Scorpion Deathlock. He wins it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match is Sting.
Oh, what a night it will be. 28 days from now. Super Brawl 2. Exclusively on pay-per-view. The look in his eye tells the story. The Little Stingers nationwide, with their faces painted, they will be ready to support their man as he challenges for the title, and we'll be back. Wyndham, Austin, the TV title is next.
All the superstars of who? Championship Wrestling are coming to a location near you. Make sure you're at the Omni in the capital city of Atlanta, GA, Sunday night, February night, to check out Crashing Rick Rude. Dustin Rhodes will be rocking the Bayfront Center in St. Pete, Sunday night, February 8th. This Friday night, you'll want to be at the Coliseum in Jacksonville to check out you. Beautiful Bobby, Hitman Hammer. At the Civic Center in Savannah this Thursday night, bell time of 7:30. This Monday, be at the Civic Center in Montgomery to check out Cactus Jack. Tomorrow night, you'll want to be at the Civic Center in Philadelphia, PA to see Barry Windham. Action begins at 7:30. But tonight, it's the University Hall in Charlottesville. That's where Arn Anderson will be. You'll want to be there too. Bell time of 8 o'clock tonight in Charlottesville.
Double, double your refreshments. Double, double your enjoyment. Oh, no, single gum. Double freshens your mouth like double mint gum. Double, double your refreshments. Double, double your delightment. Oh, no, single gum. Double freshens your mouth like double fresh, double good. Come on and double mint gum.
There's no single gum like.
The actual size of a Jolly Rancher candy is 3/4 of an inch by 3/4 of an inch square. But the actual taste of a Jolly Rancher candy is immeasurable. Jolly Rancher candy, the great taste of fruit squared.
What is real?
Is that for real?
That can't be real.
What about her? Is she for real?
Well, what is real?
This is real.
Skittles.
Tart and tangy. Wildberry. Tropical. Real fun. Real good. With real fruit juices.
Skittles. Bite-sized candies.
Rainbow.
Be afraid. Be very afraid. One life-sucking Metroid survived the first Metroid adventure, and it's multiplying rapidly. You must help Samus save the universe again in Metroid 2. So we're giving you more power and mightier weapons to search a bigger world where hundreds of strange enemy life forms lurk. Destroy or be destroyed.
Metroid 2, The Return of Samus, only on Game Boy.
The future is in your hands.
Mince fresh herbs and spices, slice or dice celery, onions, garlic, chopped nuts, tenderize meats, fix veal for scallopini, and make homemade pasta too. Introducing Rolla Magic, the hand-controlled food processor that works like magic as its five super-sized blades chop onions, minced garlic, or fresh parsley. Slice and dice celery for salads or stir-fry dishes. Make carrot and celery sticks. Turn cabbage into coleslaw or health salad. Rolla Magic is easy to clean, just wash and let dry. Its blades are stainless steel and never need sharpening. The pressure of your hand is all it takes. Order now, and Rolla Magic can be yours for only $19.95. Plus, as a special bonus, you'll get the meat tenderizer unit, five supersized cleated blades that tenderize meats. Together, a $44.95 value, yours for only $19.95.
Credit card users, call toll-free 1-800-433-5300. To order by mail, call toll-free for mail address. Sorry, no CODs. Credit card users, call now 1-800-433-5300.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is for the WCW World Television Championship. It is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by the CEO of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously, from Hollywood, California, weighing 258 pounds, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Well, Paul E. Dangerously trying to be Newt Rodney or somebody, giving a pep talk to Stunning Steve Austin, who is still a little bit lame from last week, and this man.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 270 pounds, Barry Windham.
Well, you want intensity? You want to talk about physical focus? You want to talk about a man that knows what he wants? Barry Windham wanted to break the leg of Stunning Steve last week. He wants Larry the Crunch Zbyszko. He wants anybody in the Dangerous Alliance. And I'll tell you something, you better beware of that big Texan from Sweetwater. He's going right back to work on that leg. Working on the leg. Austin's got it heavily wrapped. And he is in trouble already. And this is for the World Television Championship. In the ropes. And old Newt Rodney over there wanting a break. All the pep talk in the world's not going to help him with Barry Windham. Windham kicked outside. Windham, that right hand, still heavily, heavily wrapped. And he probably, in all reality, shouldn't be wrestling right now. But that's the kind of man Barry Windham is. Oh, right there could be an equalizing factor. Austin ramming Windham's hand into the steel. Both men now got to play with pain. Oh. Austin going for that protective wrapping, trying to get it off. Big Barry Windham raked the eyes, and he knows how to fight dirty. He'll do it any way you want. Brings that leg. Austin's leg certainly could be damaged here. I mean, extensively damaged, as Windham tries to take that protective wrapping off the knee. Again, working on the leg. I've never seen anybody that wild-eyed, that look of intensity that Windham has. Probably sitting at home saying, well, what do you expect? Dangerous Alliance destroyed his hand. Try to put him out of his sport. And it's not been a good day for Coach Rodney here. He's having a hard time. I'll tell you, a steamboat on his mind. Steiner Brothers breathing down his throat. The Dangerous Alliance is under almost a make-or-break situation in the next 28 days. Winning with those chops. But I want to tell you, fans, as much as we're looking forward to Super Brawl, the next 4 weeks are going to be very important. You got to think that there's going to be some people that are advertised to wrestle at Super Brawl that just may not make it. That's how intense it is here in WCW right now. As Barry continues relentlessly to work on the leg of Austin. He's not going for headlocks. He's not going for arm locks. Well, you might as well look, Paul, because it's a reality. The television championship may be about to leave the Dangerous Alliance. Dangerously screaming something. He's on the telephone. He is frantic here. Austin's leg may snap at any moment.
Help him! Larry! Arn! Help!
Wyndham shoving the referee down. Dangerously in. He's going to try to help his man, but Barry shoved him away. Dangerously trying to go for the telephone. Wyndham holding the rope for leverage. Referee calling for the bell. And now here they come. Zbyszko and Anderson stomping away at Barry Wyndham. Wyndham's hand, that's what they're going for. They're going for his hand here. Austin's leg may be severely damaged, but right now they're going for his hand. Beautiful Bobby on top. Here come the Steiner brothers. The Steiner brothers hit the ring. Rick and Scott Steiner coming to Barry Wyndham's aid. And we'll be back. It's Rude and Z-Man.
Next. Milk is sure helping me get stronger. Back when I started high school, guys pushed me around. Just because I was smaller. But I was working out, drinking milk, developing my muscles. By senior year, milk had made a difference.
Pardon me, guys.
I love this part.
Pardon me, guys.
So as you can see, it pays to be big on milk. Milk. It does a body good.
The actual size of a Jolly Rancher candy is 3/4 of an inch by 3/4 of an inch square. Of a Jolly Rancher candy is immeasurable. Jolly Rancher candy, the great taste of fruit, squared.
Head and Shoulders for my serious dandruff? Blue is better. Extra medicated Selsun Blue.
With a medicine doctors recommend most. Medicine that relieves flaking better than Head and Shoulders.
Blue is better.
Selsun Blue, doctor recommended number one.
If sit-ups aren't for you, watch closely. The Tummy Sizer method helps you firm the upper and lower abdominals with an isometric exercise that's so simple, you can do it standing, sitting, or even reclining. Workouts take just minutes. Just extend and contract your stomach muscles, then relax. The Tummy Sizer helps you perform the exercise correctly, even if you can't do a single sit-up.
That's why I love the Tummy Sizer method. It's the way I like to work out.
Knock off for the day.
He shoots and scores!
The Olympics are on TNT.
Tomorrow night on TBS, Ernest Borgnine in The Dirty Dozen, The Next Mission. And at 9, Robert Urich hosts National Geographic Explorer. Coming up tomorrow night on TBS.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to WCW. Before we see Z-Man take on Ravishing Rick Rude, let's hear these comments from Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Every wrestler, and in his career, he strives to get to the top of the mountain. He climbs that ladder rung by rung, and every now and then he gets knocked back down, but if he's a true professional, he will keep on going. January the 21st in a clash right here in Topeka, I had a match and my partner was Sting. It was one of those classic moments in which the whole nation was watching. It was a classic moment to go up against Rick Rude and Steve Austin. A moment to where maybe the Dragon could get a pin or a win over either one of them. And I could look further down that long, long road and get a title shot with one of them. Well, as the night wore on, as that match wore on, the pin took place. Then afterwards, the Rude awakened. Not one, but two. As I was laying there senseless, that man with the mustache, the one they call Ravishing Rick Rude, standing over me, talking so loud as he spit in my face, took that belt and whipped me like a dog, screaming at me and laughing at me and making fun. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, you think your fire's so hot right now? Well, take this and take this. And time again, he kept whipping me with that belt. Well, now, Ravishing Rick Rude, you have brought the dragon out of Ricky Steamboat. At Super Brawl 2, I will have mine. I will have mine against you, Ravishing Rick Rude. The U.S. Heavyweight Championship has been put on the line. Now the dragon's gonna breathe fire, and you are the one to burn.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, being led to the ring by the Chief Executive Officer of the Dangerous Alliance, Paul E. Dangerously. He's from Robbinsdale, Minnesota. He weighs 255 pounds. The United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Cut the music. What I'd like to have right now is for all you stink breath heartland heifers, keep the noise down while I take my robe off and show the ladies what a real sexy man is supposed to look like. Hit the music.
Well, sexy's not gonna get it when he meets the dragon. It's not gonna be a beauty contest. It's not gonna be the dating game. It's gonna be wrestling, WCW style. If you heard Steamboat's comments last week, obviously he was incensed. Equally as focused as this week. And now we know at Super Brawl 2, they will meet for the U.S. title.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 241 pounds, the Z-Man.
Z-Man, a great competitor here. This is going to be a tremendous matchup. Both these young men from the state of Minnesota, Rude from Robbinsdale, that man, Z-Man from Minneapolis. But what a match, I cannot wait. As it shapes up, without a doubt, Super Brawl 92, the biggest pay-per-view extravaganza in WCW history. Luger and Sting for the world title, Rude and Steamboat for the U.S. title, and Jushin Thunder Liger and Flying Brian Pillman for the light heavyweight title. And we'll have more signings right here next week on TBS. Rude, very uncharacteristic, that Ravishing Rick Rude has a clean break. I remember the Clash of Champions. That statement somewhat offended Jesse the Body Ventura, who, as you all know, will be in Super Brawl to broadcast the event. Rude, that right hand now, trying to open up the advantage. Z-Man has got great quickness and resiliency, avoided that clothesline, and came back with a crossbody press. Near fall, drop kick, and another drop kick. Ravishing Rick Rude in trouble here by the Z-Man. Right into the arm drag. And you've got to believe, ladies and gentlemen, that Rude has to be thinking about Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. He knows that he has provoked Steamboat into a state of mind that none of us have ever seen before. And they will meet for the United States Heavyweight Championship. You can be a part of it by being with us in the Mecca in Milwaukee or by calling your local cable company and ordering Super Brawl 2 on Leap Year Day, Saturday, February 29th. Side headlock takeover. Dangerously doing some coaching. Maybe we need a telestrator on our next broadcast. We can circle Paul and kind of keep our eye on him. Rude. Magnificent upper body strength, to say the least. And now Z-Man trying to get underneath. Overhand wrist lock. Test of strength now. Both men about even. And Rude takes the easy way out. His big mouth manager distracted the referee, and Rude pulled ahead. Oh, yeah, he'll tell the truth. You ought to believe him. Watch his nose grow as he speaks. He's very sensitive when it comes to people pulling their hair or any hair loss situation. Z-Man back up. Now, good move by Z-Man into that hammer lock. Rude is a number one contender, as you know, in the WCW top 10. And the Z-Man right now really came to compete here. You're saying, well, obviously he came to compete, but I mean, this kid from Minneapolis is really fired up. And he is posing a very, very stern test. Rude obviously not very pleased at what is transpiring here. Rude in the ropes. Z-Man the clean break. Rude trying to keep the soreness away from that shoulder, keep the circulation out. Dangerously with some words of wisdom to his United States heavyweight champion. I know many of you fans have followed WCW for quite some time, but have any of you ever seen Ricky the Dragon Steamboat more focused, more ready mentally? You know he's going to be ready physically, but more ready mentally for Super Brawl. And now look at Rude open up, working on the lower back of the Z-Man. Perhaps dangerously knows that Z-Man has some sort of lower back condition that would make him susceptible to those blows. Rude has certainly turned it up a notch here and has reasserted himself offensively in the contest. Remember tomorrow, the main event with Tony Schiavone and Missy Hyatt, Ron Simmons and Abdullah the Butcher. Can Ron Simmons press Abdullah as they take on Cactus Jack and Larry Zbyszko? Main event continues tomorrow on TBS. 6:05 Eastern, 5:05 Central. Rude calling out Steamboat's name. Drop the
Steamboat. Come on.
Well, to the best of my knowledge, the Dragon is not in the arena. He made his comments earlier, much earlier today, and it's not here. I think Rude is aware of that. Camel clutch applied by the United States champion puts tremendous pressure on the lower back and the neck. Fans, we've got a great broadcast here next Saturday. I'm not at liberty to tell you the main event, but there's a couple of big things if they get signed this week. You just will not believe. You don't want to miss it right here next Saturday, as we are only 28 days away from Super Brawl 92. And the action just keeps getting better and better here in WCW as Rude continues to work on the lower back. Really an arrogant individual. Hammers away at the back. Surely can't.
Come on, Steamboat! You want some of this? Come on, Steamboat!
You've only got 4 weeks to wait for the U.S. title matchup. That is, if Steamboat doesn't put him out of action between now and then, and don't think fans that couldn't happen. Steamboat doesn't care where it is or when it is. He gets the opportunity to meet Rude. The arrogant cover didn't get the three. Z-Man able to kick out. And what a broadcast we've had here. We're glad you are with us here on TBS.
Oh, oh my back, no. I'm hurt. Oh.
Z-Man's back really giving him some problems. Dangerously apparently knew something about the lower back. Because after his conference with Rude, that has been their focus. Z-Man ran face first into the canvas. And right now, this one belongs to the United States heavyweight champion, who quite frankly is really controlling the Z-Man. And as I have said on many occasions, the Z-Man is an awesome athlete. And Z-Man backing down Pauly dangerously here. And but behind, you better look out! From behind, it was Z-Man. But just flattened by Rude.
You like that, Steamboat? Come on. Come on.
Z-Man, that nail from behind, dropped over the security railing.
My back, ref. My back.
The ref might want to think about stopping this one. His back really injured here. He's writhing in pain. The outside of the ring, he may not be able to make it back in.
Mr. Young's a commentator yet.
Z-Man taking a chance, but he fell on his back. Rude trying to keep his balance. He can't do it. And he couldn't hold him down. Z-Man's upper body strength has to be really lessened here after the punishment he's taken on his lower back. And now it's a reverse chin lock applied by ravishing Rick Rude. Well, from what we have heard from Harley Race, Lex Luger, an intensive training will be perhaps bigger and stronger and in better shape than at any time in his adult life for his matchup with Sting for the world title at Super Brawl 2. And Z-Man with a very resourceful move, and now the ravishing one will take a chance. And Z-Man caught it with the right hand. And he got, well, he took a chance there. Stun gun, a la the world television champion, stunning Steve Austin. And here comes the Rude Awakening. He got him with a Rude Awakening and a decisive victory for the U.S. champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the United States heavyweight champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Rude and Steamboat will meet for the U.S. title at Super Brawl on pay-per-view. That is, if Rude makes it until Super Brawl 92. Fans, don't forget tomorrow in the main event, Ron Simmons and Abdullah the Butcher. How will they coexist when they meet Cactus Jack and Larry the Cruncher Zbyszko? For everyone here at TBS, I'm Jim Ross saying so long, everybody.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following. Bart and Lisa need your help to escape from Camp Deadly in this exciting Simpsons Game Boy adventure. You'll need to survive food fights, killer bees, and Nelson the Bully. From Acclaim.
If your old cards can't cut it anymore, get a new deck of bicycle cards, because your reputation is on the table.
Slick 50 protects the vital moving parts of your engine for up to 50,000 miles. Slick 50 starting your engine without it is a terrible thing to do.